Hi everybody, and welcome to a new lesson on English Online. Today we're going to talk about contractions, but not the ones you might be familiar with, which are formal contractions. Today we'll talk about informal contractions. So first, what is a contraction in general? The word to contract means to squeeze together, and contractions are words made shorter by placing an apostrophe in the place where letters have been omitted or deleted. It's as simple as that. So informal contractions can help us to sound more fluent and more natural, and to sound like native speakers, and to feel more confident while using the English language. Let's look at some of them together here. So the first contraction we have is what have you? What have you? Usually what have you got? When you want to ask someone about what they have in their pockets, or maybe, you know, somewhere, right? The contraction here becomes, or the informal contraction is whatcha, whatcha. An example for it is whatcha got there. When you look at someone and you want to know what they have, you would say whatcha got there, whatcha got there. You see, it's easier, it's more fluent, it's more fluid, and it's not as hard to say as what have you got there. That's very long and very, let's say, native speakers don't speak that way anyway, right? But as I said before, these are informal contractions, which you should use only in informal situations with friends or family, but not in professional context, of course. The second contraction is a lot of, a lot of. Native speakers do not say or do not pronounce all the letters in these words. For example, a lot of is squeezed together and becomes a lotta, a lotta. The double T here sounds like an R, but not a stressed one, an R, like a light R. A lotta, a lotta. For example, or a D, a light D you could say. For example, I eat a lotta chocolate. Sorry, I forgot an R. Oh, sorry, not an R, but a T. I forgot a T here in this contraction. A lotta, and I added an L, right? So I eat a lotta chocolate. I eat a lotta chocolate. I like it. I eat a lotta chocolate. Let's move to the next example. Tell them, to tell someone is obvious, of course, to tell them something. But native speakers would usually say tell them. So the TH here are removed and replaced with a comma, of course, and made into one word. We should tell them the truth. We should tell them the truth, don't you think? Right? Another example is, isn't it? Native speakers again, don't say, isn't it? Oh, it's nice today, isn't it? That's really slow and not practical. They say, in it, in it. I-N-N-I-T, in it. It's blue, in it. It's blue, in it. Today is a beautiful day, in it. Another example is, I'm going to, this is like one of the most used contractions in English-speaking countries, especially in the United States, of course. They say gonna or I'ma. One of both, or one of the two, either one is correct. For example, I'm gonna talk to my mother. I'm gonna talk to my mother about something, of course. Or I'ma talk to my mother. I'ma talk to my mother tomorrow about it. I'ma talk to my mother about it. I'ma talk to my mother about it. Ought to becomes ara, ara. For example, you ara phone your mom. You oughta phone your mom. Sorry, not, there is no R here. You oughta phone your mom. You oughta phone your mom. Not ought to, but oughta. Oughta phone your mom. Has to becomes has to. Has to becomes has to. For example, John has to work today. Has to. Has to work today. He has to go to work today. He has to. All right. Used to becomes used to. Used to. She used to live in Brazil. She used to live in Brazil. Something that she did in the past. A past habit. Okay? And should have becomes all the words, usual model verbs that are used with have, get an A at the end. For example, should have becomes shoulda. He shoulda called yesterday. He shoulda called yesterday. Not should have, but he shoulda called yesterday. Could have, of course, becomes coulda. He could have been there by five, or he could have been here by five with us. He could have been here by five. All right. Would have becomes woulda. For example, he woulda arrived soon. He woulda arrived soon. He woulda arrived soon. Not he would have arrived soon. Right. Must have becomes musta. Musta. She must have been in a hurry. Oh, she left early. She must have been in a hurry. She must have been in a hurry. Some more becomes some more. Some more. So we don't have the O-M-E for some. We delete those. We replace them with an apostrophe. And then we say some more. Some more. All right. We just have a little S sound at the beginning. And that's it. Some more. For example, can I have some more water, please? Can I have some more? Some more water, please? And the last one is do you becomes do you. American speakers would usually say do you. Do you like going there? It's like a D and a plus a little G sound before the U sound or the U word. So do you like him? D, you could say D, a small G, U, then him. Do you like him? All right. So as you can see, these informal contractions can help us sound more natural and more fluent, just like native speakers. I hope this lesson was very easy for you. See you next time and take care.